Yo, 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 y'all already know what time it is, man. Y'all tuned in to the Fox Cave Chronicles. It's your girl Foxy here, and who do we have in the cave tonight?
Keep it, man. Promo, man. Almost did it done, man. We on.
Keep it. Don't be trying to talk all low and sexy, man. It's just that's speak
how I talk.
Up. Speak up. Keep it good to have you back in the cave.
I told you we'd come back.
Looking good and everything, man. We got some things we're going to chop it up about because you hit me up, and so we got to put it out there, right?
Yeah.
All right. First of all, shout out to my team once again, my guys, Rooster Black, Jonathan Hollins. Shout out to those guys. Shout out to all my awesome sponsors for season two, y'all. Ayana Pride, Steve Hendricks, Hendricks Tattoos and Piercings right here in Jackson, Mississippi. If you're trying to get tatted up, hit my guy up. If you're trying to get a piercing, hit my guy up. Google Hendricks Tattoos and Piercings. Facebook Hendricks Tattoos and Instagram Stevie Hendricks 87. That's the owner and the artist. He does an amazing job. A1 customer service, 5 stars. Hey, seriously. I've had work done by him and I can vouch for that. So, let's support black-owned businesses, y'all. For real. Cliff Brewster, Palmo Valvo, 740 Larson Street, Jackson, Mississippi. If you're looking for something nice and affordable to ride in, and you're tired of Mike and Ike in it, go hit my guy Cliff up and make sure you tell him Foxy sent you. Shout out to Arthur Toy, Latoya Lawson. She's definitely doing big things. Not only is she a black female author, but she's a female rap artist as well. She's doing books and hooks, man, for real. So, pick up that My Sitter book series on Amazon. She's getting ready to drop the next book series. And check out all her hot videos on YouTube. Follow Arthur Tort on Instagram also. Thank you for being a Silver Fox sponsor. Shout out to Benita McGee, who just wanted to support the Fox Cave just because. We appreciate you for that. Serena Davis, Paradise Skates and Events, 2460 Suite 1600, right over here on Terry Road. Listen, y'all, we have a skating rink that's open right here in Jackson. Y'all was complaining about we ain't had no skating rink, now we have one, so let's support this black-owned business. Lip Sync Friday, every Friday night. Doors open at 8, the show starts at 11. Come on out, have you a good time, and win some free cash. So, shout out to Serena, man. Doing it big over there.
That's what's up.
With the black-owned skating rink, baby. Don't play. Paradise Skates and Vince. Shout out to OG Snap. What it do, Snap?
Snap, what up?
Album getting ready to drop August the 5th. Been waiting, Snap. Now it's time. It's time. So we appreciate you for being the Red Fox sponsor, man. For real. And last but not least, shout out to Lex Luger, the Backwood Ambassador.
Big homie.
And the whole Hood Idol brand. You dig? Hood Idol Legacy Tour. Hood Idol Radio. Hood Idol Magazine. You feel me? The Trafficking Hour. Hey, the list goes on and on, man. For real. So, Lex, we appreciate you for being an audit sponsor.
Lex Luger.
For real. Y'all, I'm accepting sponsors for season three. Three. So, hit me up. I can give you the details about the 3 sponsor packages that I have available. You can do the Arctic Fox, you can do the Silver Fox, or the Red Fox. Either way, you can do. So, hit me up. Keeping.
What it do?
Let's do it, man. Let's do it. What's up? We got you back in the cave.
Yeah,
you've been doing so much since the first time I had you.
Yeah, you know, we got to get back in tune.
Yes. So, catch me up on what's been going on.
I've been blessed to come back, you know, just to do what I love to do. We're still just getting started. I'm here to help talk about the, for you to help me talk about the mixtape. It's a collaboration of, to me, I call them bangers, you know, but.
Yeah.
Some people call it good music because we got R&B, we got Southern Soul, One Time Day, maybe we got a lot of people tapping in from.
Shout out.
The way we was gonna design to do it was we was gonna take all the new artists and just try to get that music heard, but Smoke D, shout out to Smoke D UGK.
Shout out.
Smoke D said, man, why don't you do the original and the mixed in with that? So my team, Murder Gang Music, Hustle Gotti and T, shout out to Jeff and Murder Man. You know, they agreed and we're gonna take it back a little bit. We're gonna put, like, so for example, put Smoke D on there with Nico or Murder Man. You know, that's why it's gonna mix up and say, okay, you know, we was trying to get in. My look now reminds me and my young guys trying to get in. So, you know, that's good thinking. And I think shout out to Smoke B for helping me with the idea. And Batman too.
Yeah. For sure. Shout out. So Keefe, since you've been back on the scene, how successful have you been with helping the artists get noticed and heard and doing showcases and all things of that nature?
We've just been trying to do what we said we're gonna do, and with me coming back in the game, it's kind of like, it's a new element. I call it a new Mississippi movement because it was so many artists that I didn't know.
Right.
BBN, one time for BBN.
Shout out.
You know, we got Young Pop, we got Lil Lice, a lot of artists that I just wasn't tuned into, or they were too young to be rapping before I left and went to rehab. So I think for the most part, you know, we just give them a chance because, like, we getting older every day, so we gotta figure out a way to implement them and, you know, keep them on our wing and our shadow and not be haters, to not have negative energy, not, you know, do the things that mistakes that we made. And the good thing is Murder Man still rapping, and we both got the idea, the drive to, you know, want to help other artists, but we still doing our own thing at the same time, and they see that and they respect that.
Okay. Now, you have something coming up. Well, you have a lot of things coming. Okay, let's talk about the mixtape.
All right, Salute to City, Bangers. I was gonna put Bigger Ranking on there. He's a big time. He's YFN Lucci's host. Now Lucci gave him a job, but then I decided to, you know, just switch gears and go to Mississippi. So I'm let DJ Young Sean host him. That's my guy. And we just trying to. I don't rap, man. I host. I'm on some DJ Khaled type, DJ Screen, whatever you want to say. Or Keep It, man, because it really is my own name, my own style. You know, they booking me on songs to talk on them and try to be like a translator for the music, for the mixtape only, because, you know, when you get to the album, you can't do out of that, but it's good marketing,
Who are some of the artists you have on this mixtape?
Man, Murder Man, of course, Family, G Wood, Big A, BBN, Lil Tank, Chief Lay. It's a lot of Sunset Knob. I mean,
man, shout out to all those artists.
I can keep OG Real. Schnapp. OG shout Schnapp out. Got one up. Yeah, but I can't tell you the song, sorry. OG Schnapp.
Yeah.
A lot of everybody that you can name. I'm gonna come by in them 10 to 12 tracks, and hopefully the world can hear me and see.
When can we expect this?
The 29th of July. And shout out to the artists that's not from Jackson that made the cut, man. Shout out to West Point, Mississippi, my boy, Day One B-Way, man, working. Sean Scully away in Atlanta from Jackson, where I chose him, because in Atlanta, it was like a choice. Like, me and Murder went through the songs, and we said, well, this is going to be it, this is not going to be it. Day One Nico, he's on the Parkway, man, and we got some guys from Jackson.
That's what I was going to ask you, like, how did you go about picking the artists for this mixtape?
A lot of listening, a lot of judging for other people, because like I tell people all the time, it's not about what I think, it's about what people think. So get people to listen to it, run in the club, see how they're ready to it, and if it's we feel like it's a banger, we're going to, because it's not just the only one, we're going to do volume 3, just, that's why I say volume 2, because people make new music every day, new styles of music, new lanes, new genres, R&B, Southern Soul, we tapping into all markets right now.
Facts.
Got Dave Mack on the way to see us in a little bit, and I can't talk much about it, but it's all, like I said, we working. Shout out to Dave Mack, man. One of my clients.
Okay. Now, you have something else going on with the youth, where you're taking them in and, like, mentoring them. Tell me about that.
It's called, Murder Man came up with the idea. It's called Tell the Youth the Truth. We started when we were speaking to schools. We went to Alabama State, shout out to Mo Weeds, Trey Johnson, the coaches there, NBA guys. They called us. Guys from the country, from the streets, to come down there and speak with their basketball team. We started there, then we went to the CDC center where they, you know, the kids that don't want to be in school, trying to get a trade. We talked to them, told them about certain things. Then we went to Homes, shout out to Homes, my alma mater 1 year with the Goodman, Mississippi. Shout out to Coach Jason Flanagan. Okay. Went down there and Murder was down there shooting their lights out. They thought we couldn't play. So these guys got scholarships. We just want to tell them, man, hey, I was a bioplastic, tattoos all on my arm. All of my niggas.
Yeah, yeah.
Murder Man played, by everybody played. Murder Man played at Lanier. Me and Wood, we played at Murder. You know, we kind of just, that's our area to go talk to those students. Mm-hmm. And I had a trainer named Coach Omar Carter. He passed away from cancer, so I feel like the entire time he was wanting me to help out, and I was always too busy. So now I'm going to do it for him. Just to show him, like,
awesome.
Yeah, that's awesome. I miss him too. I was in rehab. I didn't get a chance to make the front of him. But hey, God good, so I like to say.
Most definitely. Okay, Keith, now, like I said, you're back on the scene now.
Yeah,
tell me what has changed since, you know what I'm saying, since then.
A lot. I mean, I'm just a business man. You know, we done a lot. We did a lot. We took losses. We've been messed over, vice versa. People may feel the same way. So now it's just about business. My attitude is basically simply just, you know, that if it ain't about the business, if, you know, I don't need no more friends. I just want to roll what we got. If we connect, we connect. If we don't, because at the end of the day, it's just a business anyway. So we're trying to get to the next level, man. We see how these guys living, you know. They living good on the same thing we doing. You know, we working hard, we rapping, you know, we promoting, we hosting. Hosting talk shows, got businesses, everybody want to get to that next level on, despite whatever situation you're in, that's right. The place to go. So if you keep from staying sidetracked and keep positive energy around you and get away from the negative energy, then it's, you can move forward. Because if you don't, you're going to be stuck in that with the lid over, like a jar. You're going to be stuck in a jar.
Yeah.
So that's something you don't want.
Exactly. Okay. Now, Keith, tell me about some of the things you got coming up currently.
Ugly Money Nietzsche, my big homie from the A, tapped in, Murder Man plug that play, that's his guy. Murder Man is celebrity in Atlanta. It's crazy. That man go to Atlanta, be crazy, like, it's crazy.
Yeah.
And he called me, told me who my people was, and Murder was like, y'all got some things y'all can talk about, because, you know, y'all do the same type of things. He just do it on another level. He can get Boosie to pull up, or Future to pull up at his event, because he's a free band A&R, so he does a showcase that give away money. We got it over here Sunday at Stage One Jackson. Artists free to sign up. If you want to perform, if you want to perform for the cash, you can perform either way. But if you have to pay $150, and you know, then we'll go from there. And that winner from Jackson will go to Atlanta, and with I think about eight more other artists, and go for the $25K. And the second one is like a feature with Moneybagg Yo. Like, he does stuff on that level. So watching him, learning from him, Herb was like, you can learn a lot from him. You know, he had a good system. So. Shout out to Ugly Money. This Sunday too, y'all. If y'all want to get on there, just holler at me. It's cool. If y'all want to do free school, if y'all want to, you know, get on the for the 25K to go to Atlanta school too, just hit me up.
What is going to be
it? It's Stage One. It's on Highway 8. I've been there once. Just Google it. Stage One. It's right off of 8, right before you get to the McDonald's. And it's right to the left, I heard, across on St. Cyrus Rally. But we'll figure that. We'll post the pictures where they're at, what street, you know, try to make sure everybody know where the venue is. That people don't really know about, but they got some good stuff over there. Yeah. Stage One Jackson.
Okay. Now, Keith, my ears have been ringing about something about a reality show stirring.
Yeah, we're working on it, finalizing everything, but so right now it's looking good. Can't tell you how everybody's going to be in it. You know I'm going to be in it, so I'm going to be the main person promoting it. I got some good people from Jackson. They want to tap us out of love life. But it's not just about that. The hip hop and everything's gonna be called real hip hop. And what they're gonna do, they're gonna try to get it sent to VH1, mm-hmm. compare them to other stations. Whichever one is full of the most drama, the most gossip, the most ratings, and people wanna see and they demand it. You know, we can try to get to that next level VH1 style. You know, maybe we can come up here and do some little stuff. You know, why you know, add everybody in it. You know,
hey, we here, man. We here.
But we definitely gonna do it starting on August 1st. Y'all see me walking around with the camera, just hop in and say hey, do something. We real people. Y'all want to get in? Again, if you don't, be like, hey, whatever you guys do. But I can say I will be in it, and I can reveal one more person. Mr. 97.7 will be in it too. So you know just how good it's gonna be. Yeah, I already said it's good. Just stay tuned. It's gonna take some time to do. We gotta get everything edited, but man, gonna be real juicy. So like I said.
Mm.
But it's cool though. It's cool. It's just about entertainment and just people learning what not to do in life, and hopefully they can learn from the mistakes I made, because I made a lot of them, and I want to just try to correct, show them that I've corrected those, because people still learn from my mistakes, because I mean, I did I made a lot of bad decisions, but good.
Yeah, that's all that matters, you know, move forward.
And see, can't think about the past.
For sure, for sure. Now, Keith, I'm going to ask you this now. A lot of artists feel like doing showcases are a waste of time.
That's how they feel. We feel like this. No one's giving you a platform to perform. I don't see it, other than people. Of course, we try to make some money because our time involved, but it's not about the money with me. It's about just, because I've let a lot of artists on there for free because I believe in their craft, and if they tell me they don't have no money, I help them. I don't tell them to put it out there. A lot of artists are bashed for that, so I think that's why mine be a little more successful, because it's not about the money with me. Like, if you can help me try to build my career to pay me something, but if you really can't and you tell me you can't do it, that's what it's about then. But I think that's what they say. I don't get mad at them. I look at why they say the thing they say. Like, that just told me he was frustrated because he either couldn't afford it or he didn't want to, he just felt like it wasn't going to benefit him. So I tell him to do it for free. See if it helps. It's no problem. Oh, I pay the promoter. I pay it out of my pocket. Like, I care about these artists for real. I don't just do this for Instagram. Like, that's why I told you I'd be on there, but I really be posting my stuff to promote. But
right.
Got real life, got real kids, real child. I just found my baby 15 years old to go meet her for the first time. Like,
man,
it's crazy.
Good. Congratulations.
That was a blessing.
Yes, most definitely.
Shout out to Naya. I love you. Daddy, love you. All three of my old girls. Got three girls. All right.
So, Kevin, what can we expect from you in the future, man? What we got to look
Murder Gang Music,
to?
Man. Murder Gang Music, Hustle God ENT. Problem that we got with Murder Man right now is it's two things. We're looking for a definite singer that we're going to go with, because it's a good problem to have, because you got so many and you want to make sure that singer gets displayed and marketed right. Because we've already promoted Murder Man to the death of me. It's more so now we just got to market him to the next level. That's what we're trying to do. And I think that will deter which way we need to go. You know, and that's with anything. Like, you have to see where you want to go. And that's the problem that we got is good problems. Like, we got so many bangers that we don't know what to do. Me and Snap talked about that in Secrets for the showcase for QC. Like, man, we got so many good songs, it's hard because you don't want to put this out. You should have put that one out. So, you know, just let the people decide. That's all I tell them. At the end of the day, that's what make or break your career, song, everything. That's in my book. Mm-hmm.
Well, Keith, since you've been back on the scene, what do you think about the Mississippi music scene now?
I love it. We got a lot of artists that I didn't know that was surrounding the area and just about Jackson no more. Like, I'm from Jackson. It's going to be on my own Jack time until I die, but I'm a fair guy. I'm all about who's working, because I know where I'm trying to go. And if I don't feel like I'm on top, or I don't feel like that, or if I don't practice like that, then I'm not. So there's a lot of guys in the country, though, like Walter G. They want to be way in West, want to be. I hadn't even tapped into. Got Dope Boy D up there and Go Put Murder, put me on him. That's Murder. That's Murder Boy.
Yes.
You know, it's a lot of Sean Scully in the A, Chief Lay. I mean, you can go on and on. So I think, you know, just, it's crazy. It's amazing. Like, these guys are really talented. They got some good stuff that's supposed to be on the next level, I think.
What about our female rap artists?
They vibe. I've dealt with a lot of them. Coco Cali, T-Don, the Django. It's a few of them, you know, that I feel like that can get done with the best of, seriously. Because, I mean, Mississippi music was born here. Like, we got to be the best.
I feel like our female rap artists need to be promoted just as well as the guys do. Like hard, like y'all promote the guys, man. Like, y'all promote the hell out of these guys.
I never looked at it like
but
that.
But our females, man, y'all just, you know, like,
right.
Y'all overlook them. And come on, man, we gotta put them out there.
We apologize
hard,
for that. We
hard.
Wasn't trying to. We didn't think about that. Like, you just put something on my mind. Like, we're going to do that. That's something that, see, we're about getting better. We're not
y'all
about
ain't got no female rap artists on the murder gang?
Yeah, T-Dunn. She's from Meridian. She going hard.
Okay, we
got
to get her on the first game.
Yeah, well, she
I ain't
about
no
to do virtual. Yeah,
I
but she stay in Meridian. But she going to come down here. But shout out to T-Don. Yeah. She watching right now. I told her I was about to be on.
Yeah.
She called me early.
Come on to the 5K, boo. Meridian ain't there for real.
Okay. And she ain't had a bird asking, so yeah, they really ain't for us.
It's still, right. You know, come on. We got to chop it up with her.
Nah, you right. Females don't get the credit they deserve. I think that we got some hard females out there. And you just put it in my mind and start watching them. I mean, most people don't even be like, we did this. Look, nah, we not perfect.
They singing, they rapping, they singing and rapping.
I got one from recently, Mississippi, Lou. Lou the right. Y'all about to hear from her. She got her song about to hit the radio because she on some Rihanna type level. It's serious. Real serious.
Well, shout out to my girl Bonnie, because I know she's definitely putting that work in. She doing shows.
They send me the music.
She just came back from the ATL and killed it out there.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So I'm going to shout out to her.
And shout out to Judah.
One thing I can say about
shout out to Judah Dunn, too, for sure. For sure. Judah Dunn, I got to get you on the Fox page. Come on, man. I'm going to shoot you a DM.
Jewel stay tapped in, and Jewel opened a new idea, and she opened to do a lot of things with you. I support what she got going on. Like, I was trying to do something with her, but I had a lot of time to break. It was crazy. It was a mix-up. So, but we just want to continue to, you know, just get better. We're not perfect.
Yeah.
We're going to make mistakes. Nobody, everybody, it's a grind. Like, with the female situation, you right. I didn't think about that. I worked with a few of them. Think about
this,
something
yeah.
We gotta tap into.
We got a lot of them right here. Up under our nose. You know, and I had plenty of them on the show, you know, like that I didn't even know about. So that's what I love so much
can
about.
Can I mark something real quick? Just two things. I wanna say to
they trying to cut me off though.
So sad.
Go ahead.
I had to get
go ahead, because I forgot my thought, man. Go ahead.
You got two things. Murder Gang Studios, you need studio time, man. Hit us up, man. Hit us up in the meeting lane. I got another studio as well. The great sign, my boy Picasso Studio. Stankin' Rocket headquarters, man. Got two extra studios, and I say y'all don't have no reason to say this. Y'all ain't no place to record. So hit me up if y'all need studio time. So sorry. Go ahead.
All right, come on through with the studio time. Studios. Right. Two of them.
Good.
Okay. Dig that. I don't know how to forget what I was gonna say next.
My bad.
For real. Well, keep it tell the people how can they reach out to you.
Man, you got D in the B in the line now, man. We certified looking in the bio, it's the numbers in the bio. I don't remember about her marketing, you know, so you gotta remember the numbers. Think 965-6793 if I'm mistaken. That's the hit us up. Or DM Murder Gang Music or Hustle Guy DNT. You can reach us at both, it's all the same, but shout out to Jeff, CEO, Hustle Guy DNT. That's the label that we're working with right now. Murder kind of we sitting back deciding on what we're gonna do, but you know, but you still contact. We all a family, so we'll figure it out. We'll get you there. You wanna book me, Murder Man, Wood, Silk, Lil John, you know, got a whole squad, just hit us up, we'll get you the right direction.
Okay, cool things, cool things. Do we have any questions from the studio audience?
Shout out to John Washington, man. That's the big homie.
No question?
No, ma'am. You asked the question I wanted to know.
Okay.
What's wrong with that?
About the females.
Oh, my bad. She on there. She in there. With them women, once they hear what
this
all
that. Shout out to Butter Bolden, man. Shout out to my assistant, Butter Bolden.
In the building.
With them women, that's all that was on, man.
And my girl, Bonnie, for sure. Again.
Hey, shout out to the ladies working, though. Shout out to K-Witch, the ones that been working, bro. Like, seriously. Like, they, we overlooked y'all. That's all I can say. We shouldn't do that. We should focus on the whole situation.
Man, I gotta bring K-Wiz to the show.
Yeah, it's
right?
My girl, man. I ain't seen her in a minute.
Chop it up with her. For real.
Fam, though. She good people.
Yeah. Okay, keeping any encouraging words for the artist that's watching?
Oh, the artist. I thought you said the artist. How about I said Nah, seriously, though. Nah, just keep grinding, though, man. It's hey, listen. If y'all don't hear anything, else, hear this. Nobody made this shit. I'm no bigger than you. You no bigger than me. So let's just work together and try to figure something out to where we can get the, you know, we may get more attention on what we got going on because we're a little older, but don't think that we're here to help, man. That's how we're about. I love helping people. I got a whole academy with young kids that we sit there and we help kids with artist development at Murder Gang Studios and at Picasso Studios because we have so many we have to put them up at both spots. They want it. They want to get better. So that's our purpose. God chose me to do that purpose to help. I wanted to help basketball players, but now it's to help artists to just young companies and see. You know, like they can do anything they put their mind to.
I'm good at that. That's awesome.
Yeah, it's real sweet. Real simple.
Yes, I love that.
Artist development, real.
I love it. Now, how can the artists, if they want to get on Salute to Season 3, what they got to do?
Send me the music now. Man, y'all know one thing, man. I'm too real with this. If it's a bang, I'm gonna promote it. We want some promotion, we're gonna if it ain't just ain't no if it's something that you vibe to, you know y'all wanna get promoted, we're gonna do that. But if it's a banger, that ain't my point. If it's a banger, it's gonna be out there the right way. Cause we remember when Roof, Isaiah Ben Laden was in the club, Hollywood Luck pulling my pants. It takes the people to push them song. Murder Man had the Scotty that was running everywhere with T. Lewis, like when T. Lewis was back home. So he said, y'all, Mohead Mike, everybody get behind Mohead Mike, go crazy. Like, I mean, That's what it's about. So we just never went from the old school system. It's just support your people. I don't know what this new wave came in about. I'm this side, this side. Man, it's Jackson, man. You separated by one railroad track, man. Come on, we gotta stick together, man. That's what I've been standing on. Even with my people, they tell me like, man, you can't, nah, bro. I know what I'm trying. Unity is what we need. That's why Big Walk made it, cause like Murray was telling me, like, that man got a whole time behind him. Just signed 1017, Gucci, Big Boy, like, seriously. So we gotta do the same thing, cause we the capital, man. We the capital.
Thanks. Thanks. That's what I'm talking about, man.
Okay, Keith,
I appreciate you for swinging down on me.
Always, anytime.
You know,
I'm
always welcome. All you gotta do is just hit me up.
I'll be watching you do your thing. I'll be liking it. Hit me up. John was finna buy me a whole day. When I fought with the red, John was like, man, I ain't dying, Keith. I had you, man. Sit up. But 2 years, I had to go come back. We might, let me see if I can text John about that, though.
Baby, don't play.
Nah, man. Hey, shout out to Designer's Grill. Looking good. Hey, y'all come check Designer's Grill out, man. Hey, it look good in here, man. Hey, John got it going. Y'all got it going on here.
Shout out to my manager, man. Hey,
long live Mr. Hemp, but hey, it's in good hands. Mr. Hemp smiling because I promise it look good in here. I saw I told her, I said, I saw the logo. I said, okay, because I don't come up stay in the country. So, hey, John got a mind and a vision, man. This is something that's hard to disachieve when you know you got a mind and a vision. How can you fail if you got a plan for it? That's why people like himself, Murder, Beans, I listen, man. These young guys don't respect OGs, man. Yo, why you think I do so well? Because your OGs keep you intact to, like, don't mess up, don't do this. That's how the gang go. The young guys think they know it, man. It's scary, man. I'm scared of it, man. I'm scared of it, but hopefully we get them intact.
Stay out the way and stay in my lane. That's all I do. We want to thank Keith, man, for swinging down on the podcast Chronicles, y'all. Don't forget, we are coming up on our 1 year anniversary, y'all.
Congratulations on
that. I just shared a post, man, when the show was first getting ready to hit. July 20th will be one full year for the 5K Chronicles, y'all. That's so amazing. July 24th, we're going to have a celebration right here at Designer's Grill, 3028 West.
Man,
don't stole me.
I'm ready.
I'm going to come back. Yeah, I'm going to come back to that. Yeah, okay. Yeah, July 24th, that's on a Saturday. We will be having the Fox Cave Chronicles 1 year anniversary celebration right here at Designer's Grill, 3028 West Northside Drive. Doors open at 7 p.m.
What's up?
Come on out and help us celebrate a whole full year of the Fox Cave Chronicles. We will have performances as well. So, y'all come on out. Come on out. We want to see everybody here. Everybody. The Fox Cave Chronicles reunion concert. The theme this time will be All White Rags to Riches Edition. This will be August the 27th, right here at Designer's Grill, 3028 West Northside Drive. This will be a celebration with performances from several of our guests from season 2. So y'all know how we do, red carpet style, but all white this time. All white, your purest white, go buy some new white. Don't wear no old white. We want all pure white in here.
Licking
come through the door. We're gonna have somebody at the door with the white O-meter. Yeah. Where they gotta scan your clothes, your white. If your white don't pass that.
Hey,
If that white don't pass that scan, we ain't gonna let you in for real.
Thinking twice before they wear that white.
I'm saying that. Like I told y'all, we're gonna end the year with the Fox Cave Chronicles Award Show. December the 11th, this award show will be for all of our guests for season 1 and 2 of the Fox Cave Chronicles. So we're going to make sure that everybody leave home with something.
Right.
So make sure you dress up. This will be red carpet style as well. You get a chance to put on your good clothes and come on out and enjoy this award show. We will have performances as well. And I'm excited about it, y'all.
What's up? what's up.
That's gonna do it. Make sure you're subscribed to the Foxy Cave Chronicles YouTube channel, where you can view all the shows from season one, the hottest interviews with Mississippi music artists, entrepreneurs, business owners, and black-owned businesses, baby. So go check out season one, and we're also beginning to upload season two as well. So if you're waiting for your shows to come up on YouTube, I will let you know, because I'm going to tag you in it. So just go ahead and subscribe to the Foxy Cave Chronicles YouTube channel. Do that. And follow Post Hop TV as well on Instagram. Join the group on Facebook. I talked to my girl, kind of dope. So we get ready to lock another date in for her to come be a guest on Post Hop TV. Hey, you know some exotic dances?
A lot of them.
I need them. Post Hop TV. Do that. Follow the Foxy Cave Chronicles on Instagram. Join the group on Facebook. We're at 1.6K members now. We might be over than it. I don't know, but I know we have climbed up there and we're steady growing. If that's a word, is that a word, steady? Well, we steady growing. I'm going to say this. So join the group on Facebook and follow the Foxy Cave Chronicles on Instagram. Y'all, as you all know, I'm nominated for Female Entertainer of the Year for the Best of Mississippi Awards. Yesterday was the last day to vote, and I mean, y'all really showed out for me, man. I'm telling you, folks was coming out of everywhere. Everybody was sending me pictures showing that they had voted. Y'all, I was so emotional. I was like, look at y'all. So I appreciate y'all. Guess what? I'm going to go down now and get my award and bring it back home for y'all, baby, because I did this for Jacktown, baby. This is who I did it for, Jacktown. So, I've already claimed it. I won. So, I'm going to get that award. August the 28th. So, thank y'all to everybody that voted for me. I appreciate that, man. Y'all put some votes in. Thank you to everybody that told people to vote. You know what I'm saying? And all that managers telling people to vote.
I'm telling you, man.
Y'all did some voting, so thank y'all. And it feels good to be honored for the hard work that you put in, you know? Right. And I don't know where that award came from. I don't know who nominated me, but thank you. I appreciate you.
Put in that work for the show. Put in that work for everything.
I appreciate
you. Deserve stuff like that. The show that you put in there.
Appreciate that. All donations are accepted. Cash F, $FOXXYFIT, FoxyFit. Send those donations in. All donations go straight to the show. I've been screaming this all season two. What y'all gonna do? Red, what y'all gonna do, man? Tune in tomorrow. We have two shows. We have Tiffany, Miss, the owner of Fat Frame. She will be our first guest tomorrow at 7:00 p.m. And we got female rap artist Ty Cage in the Fox Cave at 8:30 p.m. So I know y'all don't want to be sad on that. And I think that's about it. Once again, shout out to all my awesome sponsors. Ayanna Pryor, Steve Hendricks, Cliff Brewster, Arthur Toy, Benita McGee, Serena Davis, OG Snap, and Lex Luger, the Backwood Ambassador. Right. Thank y'all for being sponsors for season two. And shout out to my team, Rooster Black, Jonathan Hollis. Shout out to Butter Bolden. Shout out to Bonnie. Hey, don't y'all forget that you got a tip. It's going down right here at Designer's Grill for the Call Me Rude video release party. Bigelow, Big Hen, Gigi, right here. It's going down. Make sure y'all be here. Doors open at 7, and we're going to have a good time. We got performances by Lee S.C. We got Vunny performing. We got Bino performing. So y'all make sure y'all be here. You got a tent, man, at the Zama's Grill for the Comedy Room Skyscraper video release.
All
right. I think that's going to do it for tonight, y'all. We out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow.
See y'all later. Appreciate it.